news from Alaska tonight, a Palin endorsement, but it's not Governor Sarah Palin. It's her husband, Todd Palin, who's making the big announcement, making the big news. He is endorsing former Speaker of the House, Newt Gingrich. So why did he choose Speaker Gingrich? And will his wife follow suit? Todd Palin joins us by phone from Wasilla. Good evening, Todd. And tell me, why did you decide to endorse Speaker Gingrich?
Good evening, Greta. You know, I think Newt is the best conservative that can win against Obama. You know, Obama's going to have projected $1 billion war chest campaign fund, and of course he'll have a lot of the media in his corner. And Newt is a proven reformer. You have to have a proven record to go up against the Obama machine. And so he...
Wait. Go ahead, I'm sorry.
Go ahead, Greta.
I interrupted you, Todd.
What's that?
I said I interrupted you. I'm sorry. So I'll ask you that. You were going on to talk about Speaker Gingrich and why you chose him.
Well, he's just a proven reformer, Greta, and you know, he's not afraid to fight for the working man, and so that's why I'm behind him.
Did you call and tell him that you were going to choose him?
I spoke with a couple of his campaign staff today, and then eventually I spoke with Newt, yes.
Why now? Why as the polls are just about to open here in New Hampshire?
Well, watching Newt from the beginning of all the debates, I just appreciate how he gained his poll numbers back up the old-fashioned way, brain power, through the debates, and American people were watching and really impressed with Newt and his experience and his message and his ideas. So, you know, I just appreciate the fact that he didn't have to spend a lot of money to do that because he wasn't in a position to do that. But I just felt that now would be a good time. He had a good showing in Iowa. New Hampshire's up tomorrow and then South Carolina. But just to kind of, if anything, just to let him know that at least one Palin's behind him right now.
All right, you mentioned Palin. He was on with my colleague Sean Hannity about an hour ago, and he said that he had had some conversation with you, I don't know when, but that he said Sarah said a few days ago Mitt was the weakest candidate we could put up. Your thought, is that what the governor says, is that Mitt Romney is the weakest candidate the Republicans could put up?
I'm not sure if she said that or not. She may have, but I think that, you know, we need to have the strongest candidate to go up against this machine. And again, he's a proven reformer. He's worked with in the past with President Clinton, and they balanced the budget. It was huge, and he could do it again.
Do you expect, by the way, the governor to be making an endorsement anytime soon?
I'm not going to speak for her. You'll have to ask her when and if she does get behind a candidate. But for right now, at least there's one Palin behind Newt.
Do you miss the race, Todd? I mean, there's always a lot of talk about whether or not your wife would be in the race. Or are you content to watch it from the sidelines and to endorse Newt Gingrich?
Well, it's been an amazing process to watch. I just can't believe how, you know, it's just really commercialized now and all the money that's spent on the campaigning. And no, I'm glad that she decided to stick this one out.
Well, it's going to be very exciting here, and the polls open in just over an hour here in New Hampshire. And I suppose you'll be watching Alaska, and we're watching it right here. Todd, thank you.
Thank you, Greta.